That awkward moment, that awkward movie. These guys are so obnoxious. They think they know everything about women. There is nothing awkward about that. There's nothing awkward about watching three arsehole characters. I just felt really sorry for the writer because he clearly thinks he's God's gift to women. I can only imagine that guy that just hasn't grown up since college or university and he just thinks he knows everything when really you don't. There's nothing romantic about this film whatsoever. It's more along the genre of chauvinistic non-comedy. You know, I'm fine with watching characters like that, that's fine, but they need to learn something or they need to develop, and these characters don't. So all they come across is just these stupid blokes that just don't have a clue. And then I just couldn't help but think, well, why are these three actors in this film? Surely you read the script and thought, well, no, I can't get on board with this. You know, those three men must know how it is to get a woman. Not what the film does. And it's so bad, you know. And I really generally thought watching this film, I was like, how have you not damaged your career with this film? But they've managed to get out of it. You know, you've got Miles Teller with the success of Spectacular Now and Whiplash. Though he does frustrate me in this film a little bit. He's like channeling Vince Vaughn, which is just yucky. You've got Zac Efron, who's been trying his hardest to move away from High School Musical. So he did films like Parkland and Paperboy. And then in this film, all he does is just pout and get naked. It's just, you know, I'm gonna pout, I'm gonna flex, and that's me done. It's like, you've been trying your hardest to get away from this image, but he does kind of save himself at the end of the film with this, like, monologue, but it just isn't enough because the script is just horrendous. And then you've got Michael P. Jordan, who just looks baffled to be there. It's like, why am I on this set? You know, the success of Fruitvale Station and Chronicle, and then there he is doing this character. So it just didn't make any sense to me. Just everything is incredibly forced in this movie. The acting is forced, the comedy is forced, just everything is just so contrived. It's just really, it makes you feel awkward. So I suppose it does live up to the title's name.